We have this equation for C. Now we are in the lab, so we need to know the error of C. As you can see here, we have division, we have multiplication, and we have subtraction. So the easiest approach for this is to do it on steps, to do it on steps. So I will show you. Of course, you can solve it one shot, but let's simplify it. So we say let TF minus TC to be A, and T hot minus T final to be B. So then it will be C become M water multiply by A. Let me just make the water over M the unknown multiply by B. So here it's multiplication and division. We can solve it. It's one formula. But first we need to calculate A and the error of A, B and the error of B. So the error of A is equal to the error of T final plus the error of T called. As you can see, or you will see in the experimental part, in the experiment part of specific heat, we will know that the error of this thermometer, who will measure who will measure the water temperature, is half a degree. So half plus half, that is 1 degree Celsius. How about the error of B? Error of T hot plus error of T final, that means 1 plus half, because the error of the T hot, we measure it with a different thermometer, the error is 1, so it is 1.5 degree Celsius. That means error must be 1 significant digit, so it is 2 degree Celsius. So now we go back to our equation, to this equation. Error of C over C is equal error of M water over M water plus error of A over A plus error of B over B plus error of M over M. So error of C is equal C multiply by all of this. We'll just come here. You put the numbers and then you calculate the error of C. Don't forget the rules. First rule, error is 1 significant digit. Second rule, number must match error accuracy. They must match the error accuracy. Thank you for your listening.